debating the motion on the budget estimates. And most of the members have spoken and they're in agreement and in support. Under standing order number 95, I do apply to you, the speaker, to allow the mover to reply.
Order, honorable members, I'll put the question that the mover be called upon to reply. As members of that opinion say aye. With those of the current opinion say nay. The ayes have it. Mover.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. I thank all the members who have contributed to this debate and motion, Mr. Speaker, in regards to the budget estimates for financial year 2023-2024. As you have noted, Mr. Speaker, there is a lot of proposals, Mr. Speaker, on where we'll be expending our resources. We are taking 30% of our budget to education, Mr. Speaker, which is 630 billion Kenya shillings. Mr. Speaker, we have also input the monies to expend for fertilizer for our farmers. Mr. Speaker, we have also allocated 3 billion Kenya shillings that will go into finishing the ongoing ESP markets, Mr. Speaker, and many much more, Mr. Speaker, proposals. Mr. Speaker, I have listened to members, Mr. Speaker, and benefited from their opinions and contributions. What I want to assure all the members is that we'll make sure that this budget and these estimates, Mr. Speaker, will be implemented to the letter so that we continue serving the people of Kenya through this budget. Mr. Speaker, also, in terms of policy, we will endeavor to do the best, Mr. Speaker, because as members are aware, the budget itself, that is government spending and government expenditure, accounts for only around 22% of our GDP. And therefore, even in regards to, Mr. Speaker, the policy, will continue serving the people of Kenya to make agriculture viable for our farmers, to streamline, Mr. Speaker, our education, and to put all the resources into various value chains. Mr. Speaker, I thank all the members. I thank you, Mr. Speaker. I thank the National Treasury. I thank the membership of budget, all the departmental chairs, Mr. Speaker, and all the members of this house from both sides. And Mr. Speaker, having said that, I beg to reply.